Hi everyone, how are you? Fine. Okay, now this is Venkatesh Reddy from SRDGPE College. I'm going to teach JEE and NEET chemistry, that is organic chemistry second PSC, aldehydes, ketones, and carboxylic acids. Today we'll discuss some important topics about that. Okay, so now first question: which of the following reactions will not result in the formation of carbon-carbon bond? Option A, Riemann-Thiemann reaction. Option B, Friedel-Crafts oscillation. Option C, Wurtz reaction. Option D, Cannizzaro reaction. What is the right answer? Watch on the board. First option is Riemann-Thiemann reaction. In Riemann-Thiemann reaction, we are taking the phenol. The phenol is reacting with chloroform in the presence of KOH and AlCl3. Then what we are getting the product? OK and CHO, and followed by acidic hydrolysis, we are getting the salicylaldehyde. Okay, here what we can observe, the question is which does not involve the carbon-carbon bond, but here the new carbon-carbon bond has been formed, so it is not an option. Second, Friedel-Crafts oscillation. Friedel-Crafts oscillation, what we are taking? Benzene, acyl chloride CH3, COCl in the presence of AlCl3. We are getting the product is acetophenone. So here also we can observe the new carbon-carbon double bond has been formed. So next, Wurtz reaction. Wurtz reaction means alkyl halide in the presence of 2 moles of sodium, one more alkyl halide in the presence of dry ether. Why we are using dry ether? Here sodium, if you use the protic solvent like water, then it will react with that and liberates the hydrogen gas. To avoid that one, we are using dry ether as a solvent. So then what is we are getting? RR, long chain of alkyl alkane, 2NaX. So here also we can observe new double bond, new carbon-carbon bond. So now Cannizzaro reaction. Cannizzaro reaction means the aldehydes which does not contain the alpha hydrogen, formaldehyde. Formaldehyde does not have any alpha carbon and alpha hydrogen. So here we are using the base, strong base, KOH, aqueous KOH. Then what product we are going to get? HCOOK means one is the acidified product, one is the alcoholic product. Then two products we are getting. Here you can see there is no carbon-carbon double bond. So this is aldehyde, this is a acidic group, means oxidation reaction, and aldehyde alcohol reduction reaction. This is a disproportionation reaction. There is no new carbon-carbon bond. So then what is the correct option? Option is D, Cannizzaro reaction. Next question: 1 mole of a symmetrical alkane on ozonolysis gives 2 moles of an aldehyde having the molar mass of 44 U. The alkene is option A, ethene, option B, propene, option C, butene, option D, 2-butene. What is the right answer? Watch on the board. Symmetrical alkene. Symmetrical alkene means the alkene which contain double bond in middle of the organic chain. That is the point number one. Next, the alkene which on ozonolysis, it's giving the aldehyde. The aldehyde molar mass they are given as 44 U. First, we'll see the aldehydes, which is the smallest aldehyde. The smallest aldehyde I'm taking as formaldehyde. HCHO. Here carbon, carbon molar mass 12, oxygen molar mass 16, and two hydrogens. How much? 2. Then total 2 plus 6 plus 2 8, 8 plus 2 10, 30 molar mass. Next, I'm taking second one, acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, two carbons, 2 into 12, that equal to 24, and one oxygen molar mass, 1 into 16, that equal to 16, and four hydrogen, 3 plus 1, 4, four hydrogens, 4 into 1, that equal to 4. Total 6 plus 4 10, 10 plus 14, so 44 U molar mass. Molar mass is 44. So our product is acetaldehyde. So now we are going to reverse method. Acetaldehyde I'm taking CH3CHO and CHO CH3. Before giving the reactant, I want to say one information for you. See, here I'm giving any organic compound, especially alkene. If you take, when you will do the ozonolysis, O3, and in the presence of Zn and H2O, the ozonolysis product, what we have to do? The double bond will be break here, and we are getting RCHO plus RCHO. So where you broke in the double bond, there you are getting both side oxygens. Means product is like this. Here product, if you will see, here we are getting two oxygens. Observe the product and reactant. So if you know reactant, reactant bonds has to break and you have to give two oxygens. If you know products, what is the reactant? We have to remove two oxygens and add. So like that, if you remove two oxygens, then what is the product? CH3, double bond has been formed, and CH3CH. So what you are doing here? Ozonolysis in the presence of Zn and H2O. This is the product. So what is the reactant now here? So is it symmetrical or unsymmetrical? Symmetrical. So 1, 2, 3, 4 means 2-butene. So the reactant is 2-butene. So then what is the right option? Option is D, 2-butene. Next question. In the following sequence of reaction, the alkene offered the compound B, CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH3, gives O3, ozonolysis, gives H2O and Zn. The compound B is option A, CH3COCH3, option B, CH3CH2CHO, option C, CH3CHO, option D, CH3COCH3. Then what is the right answer? Then don't say we know answer. I think you know, everyone. Because of that only I have not erased the board. Okay? Previous question and this question, what is the difference? Previous question, they asked the product and they given the product and they asked the reactants. Now question, reactant they are given, they are asking the product. Then what is the right option? What is the right answer? So here, observe on the board now. 2-butene is giving the acetaldehyde. Then what is the right answer? Tell me. Watch on the monitor. Answer is C, CH3CHO. Next question. The compound formed as a result of oxidation of ethyl benzene by KMnO4 is option A, benzyl alcohol, option B, benzoic acid, option C, acetophenone, option D, benzophenone. What is the right answer? Ethyl benzene. What is ethyl benzene? Benzene C2H5. This is ethyl benzene.
Está el benzene. So we are doing the KMnO4 oxidation, strong oxidation, KMnO4. Then when you will do this KMnO4 strong oxidation, it will give the benzoic acid. What is the benzoic acid formula? Benzene upon COOH. Benzoic acid. So then what is the right answer? Answer is B. Moves to next question. Which of the following is not correct? Option A. Any aldehyde gives secondary alcohol on reduction. Option B. Reaction of vegetable oil with dilute H2SO4 gives glycerin. Option C. C2H5OH iodine with NaOH gives iodoform. Option C. Option D. Sucrose on reaction with HCl gives invert sugar. Okay. So let it be. I will go from last to first, from option D to A. Okay. Now option D. Sucrose. Sucrose formula. C12H22O11. Dilute H2SO4 means compulsory. It's containing the water molecule. Means acidified. Then it gives C6H12O6 plus C6H12O6. Means sucrose is giving glucose plus fructose. This process is called inversion of sugar. Next, if you go for option C, C2H5OH, means here the formula I'm writing CH3CH2OH. We are adding iodine and NaOH. Here you can see when you are added iodine and NaOH, you studied about haloform reaction, iodoform. The methylated aldehyde or ketones, they will participate in the haloform reaction. But here this is not aldehyde or ketone. Then how it will give the iodoform reaction? That we'll see now. Here we are adding the halogen. Halogen means iodine. Halogens are oxidizing agents. Self-oxidation takes place. Self-oxidation means this is a primary alcohol. Primary alcohol will be oxidized to aldehyde first. Then observe here, is it methylated aldehyde or not? Yes. Then, now one more molecule of I2 and KOH. Don't say, sir, you have given only one I2. Sir, we are adding iodine solution. It's containing number of iodine molecules, not only one. Okay? So then, iodoform reaction will be takes place. We are getting CHI3 plus HCOOK. Means iodoform has been formed. Now we are going esters formula generally RCOOR. When you are doing NaOH, dilute NaOH, means hydrolysis will be takes place. Then we are getting RCOOH plus ROH. This is acidified. The acidified compound reacts with again with base and it will converge to RCOONa. Okay. Now, option D correct. Option C correct. Option B correct. Don't say directly, lottery wise. Option A is correct like that. I'll explain about the option A. If you will see aldehyde, on reduction they will give primary alcohol. Why they will give only primary alcohol? Because it is present end of the chain. If you take the ketones, ketone formula RC double bond OR, then they will give the secondary alcohol. Why? Because they are present middle of the chain. So aldehyde reduction they will give always primary alcohol. But in the option A they have given secondary alcohol. So option A is wrong. Wrong means that is correct option. Moves to next question. Acetone reacted with excess of ethanol in the presence of hydrochloric acid. The product obtained is option A, CH3 twice C, OCH3OH, means hemiketol. Option B, CH3 twice C, OC2H5, OC2H5, ketol. Option C, CH3, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, CH3. Option D, CH3, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, CH2, CH2, CH3. Watch on the board. Acetone, CH3, C double bond O, CH3, I am writing. Ethanol, C2H5OH. So one time it will be react, it will form the hemiketol. Hemiketol means only one time it will give the product like this. OC2H5 and H, OH. Here one more time, but they are saying excess. Excess means excess of ethanol. So H plus is there now. So then what will happen? CH3, C, OC2H5, and it's containing lone pair, it will donate to this, then it will form OH2 plus. Then it is the better leaving group, and C2H5OH, it's containing the lone pair, then it will attack here. Then what we are getting? CH3, C, OC2H5, CH3, O, H, C2, H5, oxygen is getting the plus charge, why it is electron donor. Now it is taking back and water molecule will come. It will take the H plus and it will go as H3O plus, then CH3, O, C2, H5, CH3, OC2H5 by liberating of H3O plus. So what is the name of this product? Ketol. This name? Hemiketol. So one time acetone will react with ethyl alcohol, one time it will form the hemiketol, and it continuously reacts, it will form the ketol. So in the question they are given excess. So answer is ketol. What is our right option? Option is B. For making distinction between 2-pentanone and 3-pentanone, the reagent to be employed is option A, K2Cr2O7, H2SO4. Option B, ZnHgHCl. Option C, SCO2. Option D, iodine NaOH. What is right option? Now, 2-pentanone, CH3, C double bond O, CH2, CH2, CH3. This is a 2-pentanone. This is a 3-pentanone. So, what is the difference you can observe for both? This is the methylated group, but this is containing both side ethylated groups. But in the options they are given, one is KMN of K2CO2O7, second one is ZnHgHCl, third one is SCO2, and fourth one is iodine and NaOH. So fourth option, if you will see, iodine and NaOH, observe, iodine and NaOH if you take, then methylated group will form the CHI3, iodo form, okay? And CH3, CH2, CH2, COOK, acidified product. But it cannot form the iodo form. Why? Because means it does not contain the methyl group. So then what is the right answer? Option is D. Moves to next question. Which of the following replaces OH group present in acids by chlorine? Option A, dry Cl2. Option B, dry HCl. Option C, PCl5. Option D, none of these. What is the right answer? So, carboxylic acids, RCOOH. If you add the PCl5, then we are getting RCOCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. This is the best group to replace the OH from alcohols or carboxylic acids. Then what is the right answer? Answer C. Now we came to the end of the episode, and every student are waiting for your question, and we are getting the good competition and good SMS and response we are getting. Who is getting the prizes for them, congratulations, and we are going to do SMS for them, all the best. Now watch our question. C6H5COOH NH4OH gives A, heat gives B. The compound B is option A, acetonilide. Option B, benzonilide. Option C, acetamide. Option D, benzamide. SMS your answer to 888-448-6915 in the format SRDG CHE06 option and win attractive prizes. First 3 correct SMSs will get prizes. Okay, thank you one and all. We'll meet in next episode. Bye bye, see you.
Vidyadayini Residential School, KR Nagar, Harihar. Admissions open from nursery to 10th CBSE syllabus. Shrimati Radhabai D. Gopal Rao, PU College. Admissions open for PUC Science and Commerce. And Vidyadayini Degree College. Admissions open for BCom and BA. Contact today 944-81-15118.